Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be redoing an old video of mine about profiles, permission sets, and field level security. I've upgraded a lot of my setup since then, my microphone and my screen, so it should be a lot less painful to watch this video than to watch that video. So let's go ahead and jump into setup and we'll talk about object level security versus record level security. So object level and record level security are the two types of security that you have within Salesforce. I guess the main two types of security that you have within Salesforce. Object level and record level, it's not like a versus one or the other. It's more of they work together in harmony to create a security experience for the user and for the company. So object level security is going to be things like your org-wide defaults, your profiles, your permission sets, and your field level security, as well as restriction rules in some random cases. And then record level security are going to be things that deal with your records rather than your objects, such as things like your roles and role hierarchies, manual sharing, and sharing rules. So let's talk about these two. I like to think of an example. And this is going to be the Hogwarts library in the fictional Harry Potter books and movies. So let's think of object level security as the different sections of the library. You have different sections, possibly potions. You have the restriction section. You have the possibly the defense against the dark arts section. And these different sections are opened up based upon certain sets of criteria. Maybe you are a certain age or whatnot. So each of these sections needs to be opened up within the library. That's your object level. Record level is going to be if you have access to check out and read certain books within those sections. Maybe you have to be enrolled in the certain classes to be able to check out the books in those sections. Okay, so that's kind of a high-level overview from Harry Potter stance. Let's take this back to Salesforce. So object level is making sure that you have access to the different objects, like opportunities, contacts, cases, leads, and what you can do within those specific objects. So if you can see it, you can edit it, you can delete it, create it, that type of thing. And then for record level security, once you have the specific objects open to you, you may or may not have access to every single record within that object. So if you have a coworker that sits next to you that does your same job, you may not have access to their records unless they specifically share it with you. That's just how kind of Salesforce security works. But let's go back to object level security, which is what we are going to be mainly focusing on today. It starts off with your org-wide defaults. This is going to be the thing that establishes the baseline security. This cannot be go any more secure than this. So if your opportunities are public read-write, then everyone can read and write and create every, or can read-write and edit all the opportunities. You cannot take that back with permission sets or profiles. But if it is a private object, then you could open up access based upon the profiles permission sets that you add on top of those. So it goes org-wide is the bottom, and then it goes to profiles. Let's jump into profiles. So profiles are typically going to be based upon your job functionality. For me, I'm a system admin. That's a bad example. Because I have access to all these different things to be able to change up the org. But let's take sales, for example. So you have, let's say, three different types of salespeople. You have sales managers, you have sales reps, and you have lead generators. No matter what your level, if you are in any of these, if you're a lead generator, a sales rep, or a manager, then you'll need to have a certain baseline of functionality within Salesforce. You'll need objects or access to the opportunities, you'll need access to leads and accounts. And so that's what you would do with the profile, is possibly for the entire sales department, we'd want everyone to have access to those objects. Let me see if I can find the objects here. Objects. Scrolling down, here we go. So we want everyone to have access to those. Now we might not have delete for everyone because we might not want our lead generators to have access to delete certain things. But this just establishes a quick baseline. Also here, you can add random one-off information such as general user permissions, such as managing cases or transferring leads, as well as administration permissions such as managing public lists or managing different things within Salesforce. But that probably won't be something for the profile unless it's automatically given, such as viewing a help link that's good for everyone to see. So yeah, that's kind of profiles. You can also add different password policies and session settings, but mainly for profiles, you're going to be wanting to work off of the objects, the standard objects, and custom objects to establish a baseline for each department. So next is going to be permission sets, and permission sets look very similar to profiles. Let's go ahead and jump into this one. Actually, let's go ahead and create a new permission set. Sales manager. Okay, so if we're going towards more granularity, so we start off with org-wide defaults, which establish a baseline, and then we go to profiles, which will give more functionality than the org-wide defaults, but is usually based upon a group of users who have a similar job function. Now, permission sets are going to be for people who have a similar job function. However, just a smaller group of users or maybe a one-off user. So if we're going with this sales example, where we have the lead generators, we have the account managers, and then we have the sales managers, the sales manager is going to need more functionality than the lead generators or the account managers. So that's when a permission set would come in. We would assign the sales profile, and then we'd have a sales manager permission set to give additional functionality, possibly to give them more access to deleting records or transferring records or managing records, so then they can do better job functionality. So permission sets are used, they can assign more than one permission set, I should say that, whereas you can only assign one profile. So, and you can have multiple permission sets to one person, and you can have one person to multiple permission sets. So hopefully that made sense. Let's go ahead and change something here. Let's go ahead and add lead deleting permissions. Okay, let's go into leads, edit. And I'm just going to give them the whole thing of permission for leads so they can see all and they can modify all leads as well. So those are kind of the basics of permission sets. With both permission sets and profiles, you do need to assign them to users. So that's one thing. You can't just set it and then forget it. You do have to, after you have saved the profile or permission set, you do have to go in and assign that to the person. And then finally, we come to the field level security. So field level security just is a one-on-one basis. This comes up a lot on the admin exam, actually, where there's one random field and you only want certain people to have access to it. It is a field-by-field basis. It's the most granular that you can get with permissions in Salesforce. So it's read and edit access. Now, there might be other ways that they can get access to the fields, but let's say we only want the industry available to the sales manager, or we only want to have the number of locations available to the sales manager to edit and to read. So you can make this not editable, so only you are able to read it here in the field level permissions. So yeah, and then we would go ahead and save that. And of course, it's going to be on each different object. Whenever you set up a new field, you would set up the field level security on it as well. But yeah, that is how you do that. And let's talk about assigning it. Click Manage Assignments, Add Assignments, and then you would go ahead and choose your user to assign it to. You can assign it to multiple users. You can create a new list view. do all those fun things. And then we have assigned it to Jane Doe. So that is a very high level overview on profiles, permission sets, and field level security within Salesforce. Now, I do have an admin course that is out on Udemy now. I will leave it in the description for you to check out, where I go into detail and prepare you for the admin exam. So if you have any questions on this video, be sure to leave them down below in the comments, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Again, you can check out, I have multiple courses actually on Udemy that you can check out in the description. Like if you found this helpful, subscribe. And if you'd like to join the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. Thank you so much, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.